Hello friends, welcome to this video. In this video, I am going to talk about the antimicrobial activity or the antimicrobial assays. So before moving into the demonstration, what is antimicrobial activity and why should we do that? So first of all, know the meaning of the word antimicrobial. So it is against the microorganism. So basically, we are checking the antimicrobial effect. And there are many microorganisms which are pathogenic to the organism, to the body, which will cause innumerable number of diseases. And there are certain drugs, there are certain chemical compounds that has the effect, that has the capacity to kill that microorganism. They will inhibit the growth of the microorganism. They will not allow the microorganisms to grow. So there are various processes like cell wall inhibition, and they will make a pore in the cell wall. So if you had seen my complementary pathways video and all, I have made different classical pathway, and there are three different types of pathways. So please go do watch those video also if you want to know how exactly a microorganism is getting killed. So I will put the link in the description. So what is the effect or the mechanism that is actually happening at the molecular level? When a drug or a chemical compound enters into the microbial cell wall, it ruptures the cell wall. It creates a pore in the cell wall. How does this happen? That is called as complement pathway. So there are different paths, the mechanisms are there. So I'll give the link in the description. So please do go watch that. Then you will have a broader understanding. So when these drugs or the chemical compounds, they will inhibit the microbial growth, let it be any microorganism for that matter, microorganisms like bacteria, fungus, anything. This property or this activity is called as antimicrobial activity. In nature, plant produces such metabolites. Plant will produce certain drug molecules, secondary metabolites we call them as. These metabolites will have the effect over the microorganism to inhibit their growth. So if you take root extract, leaf extract, seed extract, stem extract or the fruit extract, the antimicrobial activity will vary. In some plant, the root extracts will have high antimicrobial effect. In some extracts, the leaf will have high antimicrobial effect. So it varies from plant species to species. That is one scenario. In another scenario, the type of extract, the type of solvent that you are using. If I am using aqueous extract water as a solvent, there will be different antimicrobial activity. If I am using methanol as a solvent, again there will be different antimicrobial activity. Because whatever type of solvent I am using, only such compounds which are soluble in that solvent will dissolve. So here I have taken the methanolic extract. So I have made a video how to prepare methanolic extract. Please do go watch that if you have not watched. So like that, you can make different extracts. You can make hexane extract, chloroform extract, petroleum ether extract, and you can check the antimicrobial activity. Which extract of which part is showing the highest antimicrobial activity? That also can be done. That is another scenario, that is another experiment. So this is the basic knowledge that you need to be having before doing any antimicrobial activity. Now, coming to the procedure, there are two major methods. There are other methods and all which I am not interested to say in this video. So there are two major methods in which you can check an antimicrobial activity. One is called as well diffusion method or well method. So what you're going to do, you're going to take the agar plate, you're going to pour the media. For example, if you're doing fungal, you will take potato dextrose media. If you're doing any antibacterial work, bacteria if you're taking, there are so many Hiller-Muller media is there, chocolate agar media is there, nutrient agar media is there, LB media is there. So any media you can take, you will pour the LB agar and you will allow it to get solidified. After it solidifies, you will take a borer. We call it as test tube borer or cork borer, and you will make a hole in that media. Or simple thing is, you can use the tip of this, pipette tips are there, right? You can take 1 ml tip and you can just press it and you can make a holes like this in the media I'm talking about. That is one thing, and that is called as well. So you will create a well over there, and then you will, before creating a well, you have to inoculate your media. If you're taking bacteria or if you're taking the spores of the fungus, you will inoculate it using a L-shaped glass rod. You will spread it. Since we are spreading it, it is also called a spread plate method. You will spread it throughout the plate nicely. Then you will make holes and you will take that piece. then the well will be created. In that well, I am going to inoculate you. I am going to add my plant extract. So you can add different concentration, like 20 microliter you can add, 50 microliter you can add, 100 microliter you can add, so that you will come to know in which concentration you will have the highest antimicrobial activity. Based on that, you can also find MIC, minimum inhibition concentration. So that also can be found out. So this is one method where you're going to use well. There is another method called as disc method. So what we are going to do is we are going to get a sterile discs like this from high media itself we can get. So this discs will be sterile, it will be packed sterile. Inside this again you will get another box like this, and please open the disc in front of the lab. So again you will get some 5 to 6 discs like this you will get. So you will get a disc like this. You can find some, 50 to 60 discs will be placed. I think 50 discs is there in this. So this entire box will be having 250 discs. So these are all sterile discs. So this has to be opened only in the lab. What we are going to do is a disc will be like this. An opened packet I am showing you. So you can find the disc like this. This is called as disc method. This disc will be having absorption capacity. So now what I am going to do, I am going to load the microbial plant extract directly into my disc. I am going to open and I am going to pipette into my disc. They will absorb the plant extract, and now then this disc I am going to place it in my plate, in my agar plate. I am going to place it in the center of the plate where I have streaked, where I have done spread plate method. Using spread plate method, I have inoculated the microorganisms on that plate. On this plate, I am going to place the disc, and we are going to leave it. If it is bacteria, we will leave it for 24 hours at 37 degrees Celsius. If it is fungus, we are going to leave it for 3-4 days. We are going to leave it at lesser temperature, around 25 to 27 degrees Celsius. So I will just show you once here, then in lab also I will explain you. For this, and you need sterile disc like this, and also you need an inoculum. So this is fungal culture. We are going to do antifungal activities. I am going to see. So this is the spore culture. So this is the Aspergillus spores I have collected. So this is the spore culture, spore inoculum we call it as. Then definitely you need the plant extract in which you are going to see the antimicrobial activity, pipette and pipette tips. This has to be all sterile. And of course you need the forceps to take the disc and place it, all those things. And you need one sterile petri plate where you will keep the disc, and then you will pipette your plant extract. And you will need your solidified media is required. Potato dextrose agar media I have taken for the fungus. So this is all, friends, this is how you do it. So one, I will just do it here and show you. So you will just take one disc outside. I will show you how a disc looks. So take a big longer forceps. So this is how a disc looks like, and the shape of the disc also varies. It comes in various shapes. This is 6 mm disc. You get 8 mm, 10 mm. So the size also varies. So it depends on that. So this is how a disc looks like. You can see the disc. So what I am going to do is, I am going to place this disc in the sterile petri plate. All these things I am doing it in lab. So this I will place it on a sterile petri plate, and on this disc I am going to, so I will just show here itself what is the method that we are going to do. So this is the sterile disc. So I am going to pipette the plant extract. So for example 30 microliter or 40 microliter or 100 microliter, I am going to pipette into this slowly, drop by drop, and wait until everything absorbs. After it is absorbs, I am just taking the disc over here and I am placing it on the media where I have already inoculated my spores, either bacteria or fungal. That I am going to place it on the media and leave it for 3 or 4 days to see its antimicrobial activity. What will happen is the metabolites that are present in the plant extract comes out, and it has the inhibitory effect. So it will kill the microorganisms and it will not allow my microorganisms to grow. So that you will find a clearance zone around this disc. There will be no microorganisms, but microorganisms will be there around the periphery of the plate. So you will measure it using a scale. 5 cm or 4 cm, the clearing zone, that is reported as your antimicrobial activity clearing zone. So if there is clearing zone of 1 cm, using a scale you measure it. If there is 3 cm, it is having higher antimicrobial activity. If the clearing zone is 8 cm, it is having even more higher antimicrobial activity. So this is the principle and methodology. One more thing I wanted to explain here again with this video, that is called as standard antibiotic disc. We need to use something control. So for that control we will use antibiotic disc. So this antibiotic disc will be coated with certain antibiotics like ampicillin and cloxacillin. So here in this disc, it is already, these discs are coated with and two antibiotics, namely ampicillin and cloxacillin. So two antibiotic discs are there. So this will act as a control. So this is standard drug. So whether our plant extract is having higher antimicrobial activity than this disc, or it is having lesser antimicrobial activity. So it is just for comparison we will use this antimicrobial disc. So this is all you should be knowing before starting your actual demonstration, actual experiment. So if you know this, then we can proceed with the how do we do it. I will show you. The sterile disc is placed on the sterile petri plate. The plant sample is taken in known concentration, in known volume. And it is added over the disc for the impregnation to occur. So in this method, when the plant solvent or the extract is added into the disc will absorb the extract and then it is placed onto the media along with the culture to screen for the antimicrobial activity. So this is the sterile disc that we are using. This is one method to do the antimicrobial assays. There are many methods like disc diffusion method, or we make a hole sort of it, well diffusion method. We create a well in the agar plate, that is called as well diffusion method. So this is called the disc diffusion method. So where the sterile disc is taken and your plant extract is pipetted into it. You can take 50 microliter, 100 microliter, 30 microliter. So in different volumes, I am going to pipette into this disc. So this disc will be having my metabolites, my plant extracts will be there. And here I have kept the media. So in this petri plate, there is media. And this media, it can be, if you're doing fungal, you have to make according to the media, like potato dextrose media. If you're doing with bacterial test, then you have to do with nutrient agar media. So different media will be there. So once this spore is taken over there and it is inoculated, then we place the disc into it. spore solution has been taken as an inoculum. And it is being inoculated into the media, potato dextrose agar media. So you can take whichever fungal or bacterial species you are working with. According to that, you can choose the media that you want. And then we are going to spread it using a sterile rod. So make sure you're spreading it evenly around the plates. Now the sterile disc in which we had inoculated the plant extract is taken and it is placed into the media. So whatever the plant extract we have added, it gets impregnated into that disc and it will release the metabolites into the media. So we just add the plant extract or whatever extracts you are having you want to experiment with into the sterile disc. Once it is added, just add it drop by drop so that it gets absorbed well. So now we are taking that disc in which the plant extract has been added and we are placing into the petri plate where the microorganisms have been inoculated. So place it in the center of the plate and give a gentle press. So this is how it looks and we will keep it for 4 to 5 days for the microorganisms to grow and then we will examine the antimicrobial activity.
Okay friends, now let me explain you about, I'll just show you the pictorial representation of the antimicrobial activity. Because of this lockdown, I was not able to show you the actual image. So I'll just show you diagrammatically over here and I will just show you some images. And with that, I'll be able to explain you how do we identify the antimicrobial activity of any plant extracts. So since because of this lockdown, I was not able to go to my lab and I couldn't get the pictures and I couldn't show you the actual result. But this is the theory or the principle behind it. So in a petri plate, you would have made some, you would have kept some disc over here in between and you would have, after streaking all the microorganisms or fungal or fungal spores or bacterial organisms, you will place your disc that is coated with your plant extract. If it is fungal, you have to leave it for 3 to 4 days, you have to leave it. If it is bacteria, within 24 hours to 36 hours, you can observe the clearing zone around the disc. For example, if this is my disc which is loaded with the plant extract, so in the surrounding vicinity, the plant extract will have that potentiality to kill that microorganism. So there will be no microorganisms growing in that vicinity area. So for example, if this in the surrounding area, there will be a clear zone. There will be no microorganisms growing around this area. So using a scale, using a normal plastic scale, 15 centimeter or 30 centimeter scale, we will measure the distance between the disc and the clearing zone. So I will measure the distance between this and the clearing zone. Say for example, it is a 2 centimeter and I will always represent it in mm. So we all know 1 centimeter is equals to 10 mm. So 2 centimeter is equals to 20 mm. So the antimicrobial activity is 20 mm for this particular plate. For example, I take another plate. In another plate, I keep the disc in between and I have given some other higher concentration of plant extract. Let me see. So here the clearing zone will be so big. So if I take a scale and if I measure that, if I take a scale and if I measure the distance, the clearing zone distance, say that it will be some 3 centimeter. Or 30 mm it will be. So for example, let me say the concentration of this disc was 10 micrograms. The concentration of this disc was 20 micrograms. So I can conclude now this concentration is having higher antimicrobial activity. It can be either fungal or it can be bacterial. So this antimicrobial, this plant extract is showing higher antimicrobial activity. So this is one way where we can come to a conclusion. For example, if you're doing it by well method, where you're making 4 wells and if you're loading the sample, so there also you can find a similar type of results can be observed. So for example, in a single petri plate, I can make 4 to 5 wells I can do. So if I take a single petri plate, if I take a single petri plate, I make 4 holes or 5 holes I do. And in each holes, I might give different extracts. For example, in the first hole, actually, whenever we are doing this, we have to write down in the top of the Petri plate, whether it is aqueous extract or methanolic extract or chloroform extract, or whether it is any control like that, we have to write it down. And whatever is the concentration, whether it is PDA media, on which microorganism we are doing this, whether it is E. coli, or the date we are going to mention, whether it is today's date 27th, like this is the date we are going to mention. So we have to write all these details, and then we will load our plant extract samples after streaking that particular microorganism. After 24 hours in case of bacteria, or after 3 to 4 days, if it is a fungal organism, if you come and observe the plate, we can find the clearing zone. For example, if it is an aqueous extract, the clearing zone will be a bit larger. If it is methanolic extract, it might be a smaller, and chloroform might be even more smaller. It depends on the plant extract. And if it is a control, it will be bigger one. So now you will measure, we'll take a scale and you will measure the clearing zone. How long is the clearing zone? And for example, this is 1 centimeter. This is 0.8 centimeter. This is 1.5 centimeter. And this is your 2.5 centimeter. After measuring the clearing zone, we will conclude that your aqueous extract is showing you the highest antimicrobial activity, but it is less when compared to your control, and it is more when compared to chloroform and your methanol. So you might put a table like this. So if you're seeing a research table, if you're seeing any research papers, they would have mentioned that in form of table. So which microorganism, what is the clearing zone? We call this as clearing zone. So like this, you're going to make it like this. So I will just show you some pictures that I've taken from the Google images. And with that, I will explain you what is clearing zone and all. Here in this picture, you can see the clearing zone. There are 4 discs or 4 wells they have made, and they have loaded a particular concentration of any one organism, and that organism is grown in your potato dextrose agar medium. You can see the clearing zone, or it is also called as your inhibition zone, because it inhibits the growth of the organism. So you have to take a scale and you have to measure this area to this area, the region from here to here you have to measure. Similarly here, the clearing zone is beautifully seen over here. There are no microorganisms that is grown. So you will take the distance between this, for example, 1 or 1.5 centimeter, that becomes your clearing zone activity. So this is one example where you can see, and this is another example. So like this was one example from the Google itself. I got this image. So you can see another example over here also. Here in one single Petri plate, you can see there are so many different organisms or different extracts also you can see over here. So you can look at this picture. They are shown with silver nanoparticles. They have done Staphylococcus aureus is the bacteria that is they have taken. They have used silver nanoparticles, silver nitrate, just distilled water. So like this, they have taken different organisms. So you can see in the E. coli, you can see the E. coli is having the larger clearing zones you can see over here. So this is how you find the clearing zone. This is your disc method, because we have placed a disc over it. You can see the disc over here. So we have placed the disc over all these things. So with this, we can come to a conclusion which plant activity or which plant extract is showing the highest antimicrobial activity. So this is how we find out the antimicrobial activity for our plant extracts. So I hope this is very much clear now. So after doing all these things, you will put a tabular column to represent your results, either for your thesis or for a research paper or for a project work, whichever project work. So you can make a tabular column like this. So whichever concentration, for example, let me take, you have taken 4 concentrations, 25 micrograms, 50 micrograms, 75 micrograms and 100 micrograms of one particular plant extract you've taken, and you've taken different organisms. It can be E. coli, it can be Staphylococcus aureus, or it can be any other organism. It can be Vibrio cholera, or it can be any other fungal organisms like Aspergillus, or it can be Penicillium, any other fungal organisms you might take. Whatever the clearing zone you get, for example, 30 millimeter, or it is 10 millimeter. If they're not showing any clearing zone, if they're not showing any inhibition zone, you can just put 0. Or if it is showing, you can write that value and you'll give the control. So as I said, you control can be your positive control, which we keep your antibiotic discs that we can keep, for example, chloramphenicol, or you can keep so many industrially commercially available antibiotics are there in the market. So you can powder them and you can put that also. If you're taking methanolic extract, then you have to put methanol as your control. If you're taking aqueous extract, you have to take water as your control. So that also you have to keep in mind. So this is one very good example. So this is how a research paper should be. If you're working with your antimicrobial activity or the plant extract. So for your reference, what I will do is I have one paper which has been published where I have done antimicrobial activity using silver nanoparticles. I've taken the weed plant. So whatever weeds are there, I've taken the weed extracts, 3-4 extracts I made, and I made a concentration silver nanoparticles. I have created, synthesized it, and I have checked the antimicrobial activity against 4 pathogenic microorganisms I have checked. So I'll give you the PDF, or I will share the link for that article in that in the description box. I will share it. You can use it for your citation, for your references, or for your for theoretical aspects. You can see that. How do we make a research paper and all? I will see. You can learn from that. So I hope this video is very helpful. If you had liked it, do give them thumbs up and share with your friends and colleagues. And do subscribe to my channel and stay in tune with me for much more biology related videos. Thank you.